Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to stage Kathy Schultz.
Workshop. Are you guys loving Nu Skin Live? Isn't this amazing? The products, the energy, the concert last night. Loved it. Are you guys ready to learn about Grow With Social? Let me tell you a little bit about our session today. We have a Facebook expert here today. I'll be talking, and then we're going to have a distributor panel. Now, part of this distributor panel, I'm hitting the wrong button. I always do that, you guys. So, the distributor panel, we're going to take questions from you. Do you guys have questions about social? Do you have questions about what to do, what's working, what's not working? QR code or this bit.ly. Write this down or scan it if you have a scanner on your phone. I'm going to leave this here for a minute. I want you to start sending us questions because we want to answer your questions. So, social. You guys ready to get started? Everybody has this? All right. I got to give translation just a minute at a time. We came up with what we call the social selling cycle. And I'm going to talk in detail about this in just a little bit. But what I want you to remember and what I want you to think about during this entire session is the business isn't different. We're just bringing in people a different way. Nu Skin is still Nu Skin. We have the same products. We have a wide variety of products. We're adding more products in all of our areas, like you've heard. We still have the competitive, leadership-driven compensation plan and the new stuff that we've learned about with Velocity. And we have this new way to acquire new customers and new business partners. And that's what we're going to talk about today, is how broad the scope is of how we can bring people in. So we're going to start with a Facebook expert. Mari Smith is here with us today. She has been quoted as the queen of Facebook. She's a premier Facebook marketing expert, a top social media thought leader. She toured with Facebook in the US in 2015, and she has over 1.7 million followers across her various social channels. She's also the author of the new relationship marketing book. Please help me welcome Mari Smith to the stage.
Thank you so much, Kathy. Hello, Nu Skin. I love you. I love you. It's an amazing, amazing company. I love your culture. I love your products. Beautiful, professional, amazing quality products. And I'll tell you what, Nu Skin is one of the most progressive in the social selling. Really, really exciting. I talked to a lot of different direct sales companies all over the country and the world, and I'm really impressed with what Nu Skin is up to. So, my friends, let's talk about this. Let's dive right in. Really exciting things for you to share here about trends. Social shopping and social selling are really big growing trends. As you know, that's why you're here. This is really good news for Nu Skin distributors. Social networks are becoming the new online marketplace. And according to recent research, more than half of consumers follow brands to see products. They follow brands on social to see products. And Facebook is the most popular site for direct purchases, as we see on the slide right here. Really exciting stuff. So, a quick example of my own personal example. I saw this video ad on Instagram just recently, and I'm a sucker for impulse buys, I'll tell you. And this was a Square video. I'm going to talk a little bit in a little minute about Square videos and how great they are. But I saw this little video on Instagram, and it's showing you these cool eyelashes that are attached to little magnets. And I'm like, oh, I have to buy. Boom, I hit that little shop now button. And they're really awesome. 6 million views on this video, and I thought it was a great example of social selling, social shopping on Instagram. Let's look at a few trends and see how the world is communicating now. On Facebook, 92% of Facebook's users access the site predominantly on mobile, mobile only. And video is extremely prominent across all Facebook and Instagram. And the third component is messaging, messaging apps. Facebook Messenger, WhatsApp. I'm talking predominantly about Facebook and Instagram here, and Messenger, but of course, WeChat, and there's many other messaging apps out there as well. And take a peek at this. Now then, Gen Z, or Gen Z, is everybody on the planet who is, some studies say 18 and under, some I've seen 20 and under, somewhere between 18, 19, 20 and under, the sweet spot being around 16, and they make up 40%, or it's at 30% right now, they're going to be 40% of the global consumer population by 2020. And this, my friends, is a huge part of your growing demographic, your up-and-coming market that you will be selling to and encouraging to come in your business. And guess what? Their favorite app, their favorite channel of Gen Z's is actually YouTube. They love YouTube. You know why? Their mom and dad, their parents aren't on there. Of course, you've got Snapchat as well as a very popular app with the younger demographic. Okay, let's talk about a couple other things. Facebook recently did a study, and they revealed that people gaze 5 times longer at video content than they do at static content on both Facebook and Instagram. My friends, as a really big takeaway from my few minutes of talk up here in this segment, you must create more video, small short form video, micro content, if you will, sharing little nuggets of your lifestyle. Really, really amazing. Kathy Schultz is amazing. She's a brilliant, she leads by example. I tell you, New Skin's lucky to have her. She is fun and quirky, and I love looking at some of her Facebook posts, and it's a great example of just sharing what you're up to. Guess what? U.S. consumers spend 5 hours per day on their mobile devices. And of that 5 hours, one full hour is on Facebook. And another half hour is on messaging apps. It's amazing. 92% are apps and 8% browser, as you can see our wonderful graphic there. A couple more stats and facts for you. This is what Facebook calls the Facebook family of apps. The number one, of course, being Facebook. And right now, there is over 2 billion monthly active users. That is the biggest by far. The next one is Messenger, over 1.3 billion active users. And watch this, my friends. If we have this conversation again 1 year from now, you will see some huge developments inside of Messenger for social commerce and for what's being called conversational commerce. Conversational commerce, really, really exciting aspect of what's happening inside of Messenger. Another Facebook-owned app, of course, is Instagram. Instagram just crossed a milestone, 800 million users. And Facebook always says that they begin to really monetize these platforms when they hit a billion users. And really cool things happening too with Instagram, that fun little magnetic false eyelashes that I showed you, quick example of Instagram impulse buying. By the way, you know you can also put clickable links now in your Instagram stories. You can have people swipe up and they'll go to the link on your Instagram stories. And you can push your Instagram stories over to your Facebook stories. That's brand new, just came out. And then the fourth app we want to talk about, of course, is WhatsApp, with 1.3 billion active users. And Facebook has intentionally not done a whole lot yet with WhatsApp, but they certainly will do. Of course, WeChat, China's WeChat, is doing extremely well, really light years ahead of, in fact, of messaging apps in the Western world. It's quite extraordinary. A couple more slides for you, and we're going to jump over to the panel and some lovely Q&A. Shout out to the lovely Sandy Tillotson. She's one of your co-founders. I love this cute little Facebook Live demo. Let me see, my friends, by show of hands, how many of you use Facebook Live? Yeah! Are you live right now? Outstanding. I love it. I love it. This is tremendous. So there are 8 billion video views per day on Facebook. And guess what? That is a 100% growth in the last 6 months alone. Extraordinary. Facebook video has increased by 94% annually in the United States. Video posts. Facebook loves video posts, especially Facebook Live. They get 135% more reach than photo posts. And one more point for you, Facebook Live, all my friends out there that were shouting out and raising their hands, Facebook Live users are 10 times more likely to comment on Facebook Lives than any other type of post. This is wonderful. This is great. This is the perfect environment to do lives and with your teams and having fun and showing off some of the great new products announced and talking to your people back home that weren't able to join you. This is a great study that my friends at BuzzSumo, they studied 100 million of the top videos on Facebook, and they put this chart together of the hottest topics. And I wanted to point out 3 in particular that are really good news for New Skin. Fashion and beauty, health and fitness, great, great, great news for topics for video. Okay, friends, a couple more for you. Square, I mentioned above a little bit ago about square videos. People are 67% more likely to watch a square video to completion. That means they watch it all the way to the end than they are a horizontal, meaning a landscape one. How do you make square video? Certainly on Instagram, really Instagram birthed, if you will. Instagram was the place where square videos were born. By the way, those of you on Twitter, how many of you use Twitter? A few, not too many. I've been watching the tweets. I have, with the hashtag NewSkinLive, I've actually got many resources are being tweeted out on at Mari Smith, M-A-R-I, that's my Twitter ID, at Mari Smith. So you'll find some great resources that I've shared on Twitter that are great to go along with these slides. And there's some great apps for creating square video. It really does perform better on both Facebook and Instagram. And certainly horizontal too, right? The story style does really well as well. Alrighty, we're almost through with this. This is Sheryl Sandberg. She's the COO of Facebook, and she really encourages all of us to create what's called snackable content, short form snackable. You really don't have to do long videos. In fact, the shorter, the better. In some instances, for if you're doing a live, you're maybe doing a demo or you're doing some tutorials, and you could go ahead and do it longer, 30 minutes, half hour, something like that. Half hour, 30 minutes. 60 minutes, I meant to say. Snackable content. And then, my friends, my number one content creation tip for you, no matter what you're creating, hopefully it's lots of video and doing lives and doing stories, but you want to have people scrolling through their feed on their mobile device, and they see your post, and they think, oh, I must share that. OMG, as I say, oh my goodness, I must share this now with my friends. It's called thumb stopping. Thumb, it stops their thumb and they want to share it. With that, my friends, I'm going to hand back to Miss Kathy and we'll be right back up in a minute. Thank you so much. We'll see you again in a second.
Thank you, Mari. Was she amazing, you guys? So amazing. We are lucky to have her here with us. Okay, so now you know a little bit about the mega trends, what's going on with Facebook, how it works, social in general. I'm going to talk just a little bit about what that means to New Skin, then we're going to go to the panel. Keep asking your questions for the panel. So, what does all of this mean for us at New Skin? How does this work with network marketing? What is social selling? Let's talk about that. Starting with the products. So, we're going to post. I'm going to go into these details in just a second. You guys will see that thing many times. It's all about your experiences with the products. How do you solve problems with products? What do you love about the products? Why do you use our products? Just like you would share a restaurant that you go to, or a favorite movie, or something else that you had a good customer experience, you want to share your experiences with our products and with our company. But starting with the products when you're brand new is a really, really critical part to this. So, first thing we do is we post. We tell our story in a picture. Now, you heard Mari talk about what is the most powerful kinds of content. videos, quick videos, square videos, which that drives every film person out there crazy because we don't want to turn our camera, but it's a true fact. Posting beautiful pictures. I mean, they don't have to be beautiful, beautiful, but you guys are beautiful people. So post your pictures of the products, tips on the products, things that we've created on the products. This LumiSpa demo is an amazing social piece to talk about that product, but you need to post about the products. That is really, really important. And make sure when you're posting about the products that you're talking about how you can solve a problem, what you love about a product, and your personal experience. Sharing other people's posts about the products is never going to attract your friends the same way that your own personal experience does. The next step is selling the products. You guys need to invite people to join the product trial, or to try this product, or to buy it from you. If you just posted about something and you didn't invite somebody to be a part of this, they wouldn't know that you sell these products. So make sure that you have a call to action in there and that you invite people. Now, don't put such a bold, like, I'm selling this product at this price and doing this. Be smart and just, but invite people. Tell them to come in, and then when they say they're interested, take it to one-on-one. That's what we do in network marketing. Message them, take it to whatever messenger app or text or however you want to do that, but take it behind, and that's where you actually do the transaction of selling the product with them. Then you come in and you buy the products. Now the difference in this for social is this is, you keep hearing people say, it's no risk. It's a free opportunity. This is what we mean by that. You're going to see what your friends are interested in, and if you know that they want to buy 5 products or 50 products, you know that before you've bought any inventory, and that's what makes this no risk. So then you come and you buy the products, and you can do fun posts about, I just have these products in stock, I'm shipping them out, here's what we have. Next, a lot of people are shipping these out on their own right now. Now, I'm going to show you some stuff about how we're going to fix this, but it's really fun. People are personalizing messages. They're giving their customers an amazing experience. Remember, you're an entrepreneur. You own your own business. Take care of your customers. Help them feel like you care about them and that it's a personal experience for them. Next thing, this is where it all keeps going. You use it to recruit or customers to reorder, and then you repeat. You have to teach your teams as leaders how to do this. You're gonna give them sample posts. You're gonna tell people that you're looking for brand ambassadors or beauty ambassadors. You can tell them how simple it is. Post, share, earn. It can be very, very simple as you're doing this, but this is how you start introducing the opportunity and when you can introduce. Now, you can introduce the opportunity first from the products, but you're going to have a better experience with brand new people if they've already had an experience selling a product or two online, and then you start teaching them how to do this as well. So, what this means is that's a lot of steps. That's a lot of work. We're going to talk to the panel about how to do all of those steps. But what we're doing at Nu Skin is we're trying to figure out how our platforms can support you. What parts of that can we as the company take off of your hands? You guys are busy. You should be recruiting. You should be finding new customers. You should be doing things with your family. Whatever it is you want to spend your time with, we want to take any extra busy work off of your hands. So we created a video for you to see some of the platform pieces that are coming. So let's take a look.
Your posts create curiosity. Your personal brand is on point. And you develop meaningful relationships with potential customers that keep you and your brand front of mind. You are a social seller. Lucky for you, social selling has never been easier, thanks to Nu Skin's My Store app. You asked for a simple way to create a personalized, seamless shopping experience for your customers, and now you have it. Simply enter the name of whoever you're sending an offer to, choose the products they desire, and share the link any way you want. each offer you create is a predetermined shopping experience. All your customers have to do is enter their shipping and payment info, and they're done. It's that simple. With My Store, there's no more wondering if customers have completed purchases or worrying about those purchases being tied to your ID. There's also no more staying up all night packing orders for your customers. We'll take care of the busy work so you can spend more time on what matters most.
So, does that look like a great option? Here's the great news about that. It's already in beta in the US and Canada. So we have this launched in beta in two of our markets, and we are working as closely as we can with all of your markets to get this out as quickly as possible. So talk to your markets, talk to your EPs or account managers, and see when it's coming to your market, because we are working tirelessly to get this to you, because we know that's a huge important part, is getting those customer sales to you. So are you guys ready for my panel? This is why you all came here. So please help me welcome Laura, Hazel, Dan, Mary, Suzanne, and Mari back to the stage. Texts through my phone that you guys are sending. So make sure that you're sending me good questions through this panel. Welcome, you guys. Oh, Suzanne's taking a selfie first. Aren't we supposed to do that at the end?
Oh, you want to do it at the end?
Come on, girl.
I'm excited.
I know you're excited. They need to hear from you. They're so excited. Okay, so let's start. I'm going to ask the whole panelists. First, you're going to tell us your name and, like, just a quick story, how long you've been doing social and how long you've been with us. And you're gonna tell us, as your first question, what the most common question you get or problem you see in social is. So introduce yourself really briefly with that. So Mary, we'll start with you.
So hi, you're like a lot. So it's such a pleasure to be here. I am Mary, I come from Argentina, Latin America. I'm developing the business with my boyfriend. We've been living like 2 months now since we are together in the same place. I've been doing social since 8 months, and I love the opportunity. I heard a lot of stories around the world, and it impressed me how it was so comfortable to work like that. So I started doing it, of course, without knowing how, because none of us know at the beginning. So I started training myself really hard and working like very hard. And people often come to me and ask me, like, how did you grow so fast? Or how is it that I can grow very, very fast? And for me, like, the key for that is you keep doing it every single day. Because people sometimes think that if you post one day and the other day, maybe because it's holiday or maybe because it's Sunday, it has no problem. Okay, so if you don't post one day, even a single one, you will have like the half of likes the day after it. So for me, like, the key is to be constant and to keep posting every day, even in Christmas, because in Sundays people are like free, so that's when they connect and that's when they go on social. So for me, like, the key is you keep posting every single day. And I think that if you do that, you only by yourself will see what is your style, what is the best, which pictures and videos and posts are the most effective, but if you don't post, you will never know. So that would be my key.
Perfect. Thank you. Hazel, introduce yourself and give us a little either pet peeve or the biggest question you get.
Okay. Hi, it is so bright up here, so it's actually quite a good thing for my nerves. So my name's Hazel, I'm from the UK, and I have been in the business around 2.5 years, and I've built through social media since day one, so that's all I've ever done, that's all I've ever known. My biggest thing that I see that I want to help people with, or what people come to me with, is sometimes people say to me, I haven't got a lifestyle that's good enough to share. And it really actually, like, it's horrible to hear that, because I remember when I started and things that, like, the car we drove, we had like 200,000 miles on the clock, and we still have that car. So we didn't have anything, our lifestyle wasn't great to share, but you need to make the most of what you do have. And we had a beautiful family, we still do, and I would always have like a family picture. Like, my son Cody would help me with our products, and he would help me do delivery runs. So you don't need to have a crazy amazing lifestyle. You are good enough with what you have now, and people will connect so much more watching you start straight from the beginning and transitioning through social.
I love that. Thank you, Hazel. Dan, tell us a little bit about your story.
Hey, so I'm Dan, also from the UK, and I've been in the business now 18 months, and since day one, again, for me, I've always been on social media. Now, for me, one of the biggest kind of problems always brought to me is the expectation of social media, is that people think that they can post an image or a toothpaste at a certain time with a certain text, and they're instantly going to get sales off the back of that. And some people think that you have to look a certain way, or that you have to have a certain amount of following, but that's not right, because it's all about your influence. You can have thousands and thousands and thousands of followers, but if you have no influence over those followers, it doesn't mean anything. I've seen people come in the business with only 200 followers, but they have such a big influence that they've been so successful with a limited with 200 people compared to thousands. And for me, that's one of the biggest things. I have people coming to me and say, you know, oh, I don't look a certain way, I have to do it this way, I have to do that way. And you're like, you don't. That's just the expectation. It's all about the influence you're going to build up with your audience, because we're all different. We all have different following sizes. We all have different audiences. I'm a man, you know, and you know, so it's just about the influence that you build with people.
He's a man, and he put it out there. Yes, thank you.
Just in case you couldn't tell.
Okay, Lara, tell us a little bit about your story. And again, the most common question that you get from your team.
Thank you. So my name's Lara Cole Felton, and I've been in the business for 29 years. This is actually my 30th convention. So it's like, I know, it's so special to me. And so I've transitioned through a lot of different ways of building the business, starting the old-fashioned way. But I started social kind of full on, I would say, July 1st, like last year. So it's just been a year and a few months. And I will say that I have never been more excited about anything in all my years, in all the product focuses, in all the new markets. I've never seen any potential than what I see right now with social. So just putting that out there. I would say that the biggest obstacle I find, or things that I see in my group and just kind of looking around, is that sometimes people start the business and they put up their first toothpaste post and they do really well and they start to get excited, and then they kind of keep posting, which you're supposed to keep posting, but they don't focus on changing up their audience. And just think about that. It's like, imagine, you know, if you started introducing the business to a small section of people, and then every day or every week you kept calling them to tell them the same thing. Like, after a while, they tune you out. So I would just say, like, the best advice that I can give within kind of the vein of that issue is that you have to be thinking about changing up your audience. You have to add new friends, you have to ask for referral posts, because once you know, ask somebody to do a referral post, you're jumping into a whole new circle of influence. And I always go back, and this has been my mantra for 29 years, I always go back to recruiting solves all problems. And it's no different in social, right? I mean, in social it just looks different because we're doing it by adding new friends and asking people to do posts. But if you really kind of keep going back to that and changing up your audience, adding your audience, so that when you post, that, you know, it's new and exciting people to look at.
Recruiting solves all your problems, guys.
Recruiting solves all.
Thank you, Lara. Suzanne?
Thank you, Kathy. So I got started, well, I've been with the company for 4.5 years now, so I've marketed all kinds of different ways, and I agree with Lara completely that this is so much fun. And I started in the summer of 2016, and it completely turned my business around, and it's just been such a blessing for me and for all of the people that I've been able to help. And so I'm so excited to share with you guys. One of the biggest questions that I get is, I'm not real active on social media. How can I make this business work? if I don't already have a following or an audience. And so one of the things that I love to teach is to think about what is your brand, what are things that are important to you, and to start sharing those things on social media so that you're attracting people to you and your life, and then you're going to expand into new networks by connecting with others who do have a social network. So it's not about who you know, but it's who they know and who they know. So you've got to think beyond your own circle of influence and the people that you're currently connected with, and just get out there and get into action. Start posting and start learning from others who are doing it, and just grow your audience like Laura mentioned.
Perfect. Now, Mari doesn't do the business, but you know Facebook better than anyone except maybe, as you call him, Zuck. She's like friends with Mark Zuckerberg, so we have that. But tell us like kind of what you think a general kind of Facebook thing is that everyone could improve on.
I'd be happy to. So I really encourage everybody to think of themselves as a personal brand. You really are. And I know predominantly in New Skin, you'll use your personal Facebook profile, perhaps your personal Instagram account, and you are the business. And so everything you post and everything you interact with, because people can watch that in their ticker, it's called, over on Facebook. So I'm always strategic. Like, my middle name is Strategic. And I remember one time, this was on Twitter years ago, and I had a colleague, he's like, Mari, I figured out your ratio. I look at all your tweets, and it's like, you're like 42% personal and, you know, 58% business. And I just laughed and I said, you know something? I am 100% business, even when I'm being personal, because I'm thinking it through. How is this going to be perceived by my audience? Does this help, or does this elevate? Does this position me well? Am I adding value? Am I giving? Am I coming from the heart? I'll ask myself, what is my deepest intent? And always, for everybody here, thinking through what you are engaging with and what you are posting is so important as a personal brand.
Love that. Thank you. Okay, we are getting good questions from the audience, you guys. Now I'm going to ask, I'm just going to pick and choose. You don't know what's going to happen now. Okay, so Hazel, I'm going to ask you this first one. Do you follow a particular post structure every day, or does the content vary at different times and daily?
Yeah, this is interesting. So when I started building social media like 2.5 years ago, things were very different to what I did then to what I have to do now. And I say back in the day like I'm a dinosaur, but 2 years ago, things have changed a lot. And we used to always teach that you have to post at certain times of the day, and that's going to really help you. It doesn't really work as much like that anymore. And you might have seen on your newsfeed, your Facebook, your Instagram, like 4 days ago, like how is that showing on the top of my newsfeed 4 days ago? And things have changed now. So it's really important to really work on your engagement side of things. So we have a structure, like we teach our teams like some daily habits, and you know, we give them a guidance of kind of how many times a day to post, but it's so important to mix up the posts as well, because you don't want to be a robot. Like, people buy from people, they don't buy from a robot or from a company as such. So it's really important to mix it up a little bit. And we don't, like I say, we don't really teach times of the day anymore. We teach about engagement and adding value to others. And I always say you need to know your audience and relate to that. So for me, it's all about working mums, because I was a working mum that was just sick and tired. So I base everything around family, and that works for me. So you need to figure out what you want to do, and then your posts will, you know, be different with that.
I love that. And I want to point out a few things that she just said. It's all about engagement. And Mary said the same thing. If she misses a day, then her engagement the next day is less. So think about how these pieces and these answers are layering on each other, that's a really important piece. And there's not a single algorithm or a single way to get the most views. You really need to just be active. So that's kind of just to drive that point home that kind of both of them just said. Okay, so who shall I choose next? Okay, Suzanne, how do you train your new recruits to do business through social?
Okay, I love this topic. So I have a template that I send to my new team members to get started, and I always tell them to personalize it and make it sound like you. If you have a personal result or a testimonial, that is going to be superior to anything that I could ever send you as a template. So keep that in mind. Send that out, and I give them instructions for what to do in the comments. So we're not going to answer questions on the post. We're going to private message people the answers and make that a personal connection. And I just continue to feed them the next step. So there's a cycle that you can go through from your first post to your last chance to get in on this post, and then your, oh my gosh, I'm so excited I made money post. And so I just send that to them through a cycle and continue feeding them the next steps for the first 7 to 10 days.
And again, I love that. You give her a shout. Now you combine what was just said. I'm just kind of bringing everything back. It's really important when someone first starts that they have structure and they know what to do. But then you have to teach them how to change that up and do things based on, like what you heard Laura say, where if they just did that same thing over and over and over, they're going to wear out a little bit. So you start with the structure with a brand new person, but then you have to continue to teach them then how to build and the power of social with that. Okay, Dan, how do you recruit distributors from social media?
So
difference from customers to distributors. Let's kind of focus on that piece.
So how I recruit distributors is I use Facebook Messenger. I'm not a fan of people posting the recruitment style posts. I know we do have to share the opportunity, but personally, I'm not a big fan of that. So what I do, I use Facebook Messenger. I'm talking to people all the time. Like, your social media business is not built around the posts you do or what your profile looks like. It's built with connecting people, networking. Like, we're in network marketing, so we need to be networking. You need to be talking to people every single day. So that's how I recruit distributors. I'm constantly, every single day, talking to people. And what I do find, back to the amount of times a day you post and what you're posting, but like Hazel said, the different style of posts, I get so many more people coming to me about the business when I'm not posting about products or the business. If I'm posting about being away with Cody or with Hazel, or, you know, when I'm taking him on the school run, because, you know, that's a big thing for me as a father, is the fact that I can take my son on the school run and I can pick him up from school, and I have that freedom. And when I share that, people come to me, they're like, wow, how are you doing that? Like, what are you doing? And then that's the way I get to recruit distributors for it. So it's just constantly talking to people, every single day talking to people.
Did you guys all hear that? It's not just about posting. You're not a billboard. You're talking to people, you're messaging them, you're building relationships, you're networking. Okay? Very important that you're not just throwing a post out there and hoping that it does all the work for you. This is a hard business, but the harder you work, the better it works for you. I don't know that that was an actual good sentence. Sorry, translators. Okay, I'm reading, I'm talking all at once. Look at me, I can chew gum and walk. Okay. I had a good one that I was going to ask you, Mary. How do you pick your target audience?
Okay, that is a very good question. For me, you have to pick the target audience. You think they're going to reflect on you. Because, for example, I could talk to people of 40 and afters, but probably people of 24, my age, or 30, they will reflect more on my story. So I would go more to people that I have my profile or my age, even a little bit upper, and then to post products that they are going to relate with them. Because if I post a product for a 40 years old person and I am showing only myself, then it would be weird. So I think you should pick the best target market that reflects you and that goes with your story, and the post must be for them. Like, you're picking one part of those incredible market and you're posting for them. So there is going to be relation and there is going to happen the magic for me.
Perfect. Okay, Lara. Okay, here, where is it? How do you use social media for your team trainings? Lara is a 20 plus year team elite, so she has a different, you know, responsibility and social than some of us, where she has huge teams. And so that's where I really want you to talk about how you use social as you're training your team, not just how you train your team on social.
Right. So
The obviously Facebook groups are magical. I mean, I think back again, it's a lot of years where every time we'd want to train an organization, it was a lot of time getting on flights and traveling and going. And still, that part of the business, that's never going away, guys. I mean, the whole relationship building, person to person, so important. But we can be so much more efficient in between all of that with Facebook groups. So what we use, and I'm sure everyone on stage here does as well, is you use Facebook groups that you can deliver content, not like, I mean, we do boot camps and things like that where we'll take a longer period of time to cover more topics. But we are finding that in today's environment, people need like little bites of information at a time. So that if they can go into your Facebook group and learn one new thing and say, look, every single day, spend 10, 15 minutes every day learning something new, watching a new video. And so and then you get together with leaders, and then you have different leaders within your organization that have achieved success. And you can use success at different bench levels, maybe people that have qualified for success trips. But you're getting different people that are good, because we're all good at different things, right? I mean, I've always said recruiting's always been my passion. You have other people that are really good with products, and other people that are really good with retention. I mean, there's so many different skills needed in the business that I love the Facebook groups for that. That's pretty much how we use. And can I just mention something that Dan said? Because Dan mentioned that, in terms of recruiting, so yes, there are recruiting posts, and some people do and some people don't. But the other thing I will say about recruiting is that people are watching you. So no matter what you're doing, even if you're just sending a welcome post or congratulation post to someone on your team, without that being a quote-unquote recruiting post, like I'm looking for five people or I'm looking to mentor people, just the fact that they see you're welcoming people to your team and you're congratulating people for success, that's like an indirect, subtle recruiting post, and that gets people to go, what are you doing? What's going on in that business? So it's kind of a critical factor.
I love that. Mari, what should absolutely be avoided when doing social marketing?
Oh gosh, where do I start? Okay, so I think actually Mary might have said it earlier, someone else up here said it, about just too much repetition. Like if I go to your personal profile and all your posts are public, and let's say I want to friend you, or I'm kind of interested in what's happening on your profile, and all I see is nothing but pitch, and there's nothing else, there's no lifestyle, there's no personal, there's no nothing, I don't really get a vibe of like who's behind the scenes. And nobody here does that anyway, so all the other people out there we're talking about. But seriously, and I'm sure that this is a common theme, and New Skin is so important to add that, we said it earlier about the personal brand and weave in components of what you're comfortable. I always like to delineate between your personal life and your private life. You decide what aspects of your personal life, it could be pets, it could be children, it could be a passion, it could be a hobby, weave all that into your social posts, but you decide what is absolutely private, and you just never put it online, because there's really no such thing as privacy online. I just said it. So, Zuck, are you listening?
That is perfect and very true, but it needs to be personal still. I love that it does. It needs to be personal, not just sales pitch. Okay, there is another one. Hazel, how do you choose products to market through social media? How do you pick which ones, and what have you found works the best?
Yeah, so I actually love this question. So, we've been working very hard the past couple of years, and we have teams in multiple markets, just like many, many other people have. And we used to hear people say this, and then when you go through it, it actually makes sense. Like, how the UK market is very different to how the market is in Malaysia, for example. Like, we have an executive growing there. And so you really need to target, it's all about your audience, and you need to know kind of the trends and how customers shop. And luckily, my background was all about customer engagement and things like that, so I could bring that to the UK. So I knew that the UK, we like beauty products, we just don't like spending a crazy amount on it. So I would look, like, what do we have? Because we have such a range of products, what do we have that totally fits here? And then, for example, in Malaysia, one of the ladies that we work with, we do exactly the same, but she picks the products that she knows will work in her market. So we really let our teams decide what fits that, and it's worked really, really well. But it's just to get to know you. We're all customers. I always say this, like people think, oh, you know, how do I attract customers? I guarantee you in the last 2-3 days, you have brought something from somewhere. We are all customers, so you just need to remember, how do I want to be treated? What do I like buying? What interests me? All of us are customers, so just remember that, and that will help you figure out what products would I like that I can share that works in my market.
I love that. And you guys, Nu Skin has a product for everybody. There aren't a lot of companies like us that honestly have the variety of products we do that you can say, who's my audience? What do they want? What market are they in? How much money does my audience have? And we have the perfect product for them. It's not about a single product. It's about answering these questions. And then we have that whole variety of products, which is an amazing part about Nu Skin. There are not a lot of our competitors that have, I don't think there's any, that have this type of a product portfolio, and we're continuing to add in all of the different areas. So you can totally answer these instead of it saying only this product sells in social. It will sell if you understand these basic principles. Okay, Mary, I have one for you. Give us an idea of, or an example of your ideal post.
Great, I love this question. So ideal post for me must have emotion in it, because if you're like, as Hazel said, like robots and just putting like what the product is about, and if you full words of science and age log, I think people get like a little like, whoa, too much information. There are different platforms, and it depends on which platform you're working on. For example, Instagram, you have to be very quick and short. Like if you do like a whole text, you have like have a very engaged audience. At the beginning, you don't have that engaged audience, so you have to be very brief and like in 2 or 3 or 4 lines, use emoticons. Did I say like that? Sorry, my English. Like, for example, if my boyfriend would post in my only Instagram, people would know it's not me because he doesn't use my emoticons. So you always have to be yourself. You have to put all the time things that you really like. Everything in Instagram, in Facebook, in any social media communicates. Even a hashtag, even an emoticon, even points, everything communicates. So for me, ideal post must be post that people understand, that people feel that you communicate on them. Of course, if you appear, that is okay, and that is the best for me, because people love to see you, love to know you. It's just like artists, like you're an artist in social media. I'm an artist in my personal life, and I compare it all the time, because for me, people is like an audience, so they want to know you. And for me, an ideal post is where you show yourself and really put the emotion in it, on a product, on the opportunity, on whatever you're showing.
Perfect. Thank you. Suzanne, why sell at retail price on social? Is this too hard of a question?
This is a really simple answer.
You didn't say, I love this question.
Why sell at retail? Because we want everybody who gets started in the business with us from day one to be making money. And they are going to maximize their time on social media, making more money, selling at retail prices. So we are going to teach them that you can make, for example, say it's a $10 markup on a product. If you sell 10 of those, you've made $100, right? So that's what we want people doing right off the bat, and that's going to attract other people to the business, and it's going to duplicate much faster.
Perfect, thank you. Now, I know that not all of our markets have retail price, and there's some different things, but it's important for you guys to understand why retail fits into social, and all of your markets, we're working on figuring out how that's going to work and all the other things. So there is my corporate Kathy disclaimer. There you have it. All right, Dan, I have one for you. And now I lost which one it was. Where is it? Okay, we're just gonna go with this one. How do you, this is the one I wanted to ask you actually, that's funny. How do you determine the potential success of new distributors? So when you bring someone on your team, how do you help them with, I wouldn't say like, oh, you're gonna be successful, you're not, but how do you kind of, when someone brand new comes in, how do you help determine their level of success and how you're gonna help them find success?
Well, I actually like that question because it's not up to me to determine their success. It's up to that person. It's not up to me to decide what they want to do. So for me, all I do is I ask them, what do you want to achieve? How much money do you want to earn? And I help them earn that money. You know, some people might want to come in and just earn £50 a month. That's perfect. I'll teach them how to do that. Some people want to build a huge business with huge income. So we teach them how to do that. It's not up to me, you know. It's completely up to that person what they want to do, how they want to build their business, how much money they want to earn, and I teach them how to do that. As a leader, as a mentor, I feel like it's my role to teach them what they want to achieve. And it's not up to me to decide what I want them to do. It's up to, the more people I help just do what they want, the more I'm going to get what I want.
And I love that because success is determined by what they need in their life. And I really love that this gives us that opportunity, that there can be all those different, you know, it's not, once you hit this, you're successful. Mari, how do we get strangers to view our posts on Facebook aside from our own friends without paying for ads? Because that's
okay.
Against our rules.
Those algorithms. So number one, Facebook right now, I mentioned in my little segment earlier, Facebook is absolutely favoring lives and stories. And I mentioned that you can do now just brand new, you can go live, you can do your story on Instagram and push it over to your Facebook. And I don't know, I think like there's 250 million active users every day using Instagram stories. I think I mentioned that earlier. So that's an incredible captive audience. And then Facebook's taking a little bit longer to catch on with the stories, but now with the ability to link them over, it's just a way to keep that top of mind, right? When you go, you open up your Instagram, you open up your Facebook, and you see the little bubbles, I call them, and you're like, oh, there's so-and-so, right? And you just tap in, and you look at them, or you interact. So that's always a good thing. And then doing, I mentioned with a square video or landscape, but ideally, number one, square, number two, portrait, and then number three, if you have to do landscape. So Facebook Lives, Facebook's algorithms are favoring them. You get more engagement, you get more reach, and then video content, all before thinking about doing links. You can do photo posts are good too. I've seen a lot of great photo posts by Nu Skin distributors as well.
Perfect. Okay, Lara, what if you don't have a lifestyle yet? Where's the attraction in the beginning? So you have someone brand new starting. How do you teach them that? And we talked a little bit about it, but I want you to drive it home again.
Well, I mean, again, we have to be authentic, right? So you can't make stuff up. So I also think that we can show lifestyle in little things. Like you could be sitting there with your little baby, you know, in some any random place, and you have a photo of you on a cell phone saying, loving that I'm working my business. I mean, in terms of, because that's lifestyle to me. That's, I'm not in a corporate office away from my child. I'm working my business from, you know, with my child. It could be something, you go to the beach one day and you take your cell phone with you and you have a photo of you doing your business from the beach. I mean, there are little things that doesn't mean that you had to fly on an expensive vacation somewhere, but you're showing lifestyle. So I think like when we, somebody just recently I saw did a picture in bed saying loving that I get to work from home from my bed today. I just saw it recently. So I've seen a lot of fun ways. I mean, yes, many of us on stage from the success trips, I will say this, do whatever it takes to get on your next success trip because people do have FOMO and they don't want to miss out on that. And so when you're on these success trips and you're showing lifestyle, it is amazing, but obviously it's a journey, you have to get there. So in the process, it could be a photo with your puppy, and like, I mean, there's so many fun ways to show what you are calling your quality of life. And I think for so many of us, it's being in control, doing, I mean, I've seen people post, they're in the post office, or they're at the bank, or they're at some random place, and they're showing that they're doing their business online, and that's lifestyle, right? It's like, again, I didn't have to get up at 6 a.m. and commute into the city and, you know, work for somebody else. So I think that's lifestyle.
Sorry.
What?
I just got the question, Laura, are you single? No, she's not. She is married, and her husband's right here.
Thank you. My husband is in the front row, but thank you.
So sorry, whoever sent that question. The beautiful Laura is married. Okay, focus, Kathy. We have just time. We're going to do our final question. So everyone's going to answer this final question for us, because I want to make sure that every one of you leaves here knowing what to do. So every one of you guys is going to give your best advice. It's going down in history, you guys. This is all recorded. Your best advice on what everyone out here can start doing in social today. Remember, there's beginners and there's pros, there's brand new distributors, there's 20-year team elites, but every one of you guys just take a minute and say, what should they start doing today in social? And we'll just, Mary, we'll start with you and we'll go down.
Great, so for me, today you have to sleep in your bed, you dream and you have a vision of what you will do with this business in your life. See, how are you going to wake up next morning, how you want to wake up in 5 years from here, you picture that in your head. When you have it picked up, you write it down, you do like a historical, how you say that? A history line, that's the thing. And you do something with that on social. You can have a video talking about how you're going to live your life. You can have a picture about that. You can have anything that reflects who you are, why are you doing this, what you want to accomplish with that. And so that people can know you better and people can know what is your purpose for life. I think that's the best way you can reach customers that will sympathize with you, like, oh my God, this girl is selling because she wants this. And also to another people that are going to realize that they have also another dreams bigger than what they are doing, so they can join your group.
Perfect, thank you. Hazel, best advice.
Okay, I'm gonna share something that I actually made up, so. I think it's all right, so hopefully no one will laugh. So when I joined the business, I had no idea what I was doing. I had really no product knowledge. I didn't understand the compensation plan. I dread to think what I was telling people when I started and they joined the business. So I had no knowledge of really anything. And I think, how did I build this business so crazy and so quick? So I came up with this thing, and I call it the four E's. If you bring excitement, engagement, and energy, it will create your environment. So that's exactly what I teach a team. You don't need to know everything, and you certainly don't need to know it quick either. Just create so much engagement online, create so much excitement, create so much energy, and you will create an amazing environment.
I love that. Did you guys get Hazel's four E's? You can rewatch this on live stream if you didn't write your notes. Dan?
So my thing for everybody is understanding that your social business isn't built based on what you're posting or what your profile picture looks like or what your profile looks like. It's actually built what you're doing behind the scenes. It's what you're doing in your messenger. It's how many people you're talking to on your newsfeed. I spend most of my time on my newsfeed connecting with people, talking with people on their posts because I want that level of engagement. What I find is if in the morning, before I do like my first post of the day, no matter what it is, it might be something to do with a gym or product or Cody, if I haven't spent time connecting with people on the newsfeed first, then I get zero engagement. But if I sit there for 5 minutes, connect with 10 to 20 people, comment, like, and all this stuff, but being authentic and being real, not just putting a simple word or something on, actually connecting with them, talking, having conversations, and then I put my post up, I find I get so much more engagement. And we've actually been doing this with a couple of our teams, and since February, we've grown a whole organization by over 40%, and we haven't once spoken about what your profile picture looks like or what you're posting, what time of day you're posting. All we have spoken about is connecting with people, engaging with people, and finding out what somebody wants and helping them achieve that, whether it's a customer or a new distributor. It's all about the other person. It's not about you.
Thank you. Love that. Lara?
I'm going to, like, play off a little on what Dan said, because it's where my mind was at also. I believe so much of this is about engagement. And what happens is with a lot of our news feeds, they're filled with our distributor friends, because we've done such a good job at supporting each other and commenting on a distributor post that you can sometimes go through your feed and not even see your non-New Skin friends posts. So you really have to go out of your way to start, you know, kind of looking through your friends list and start going to their pages and commenting and engaging. Same thing of what Dan was saying, because if you're not intentional with that, you can very quickly, your entire wall is filled up of just your existing distributors or distributor friends. So you have to go out of your way to do that. And then the other thing I would say is I'm very big on accountability. So I would just encourage everyone, when you go home, every night before you go to bed, ask yourself, you know, how many new friends did I add on Facebook? How many people did I reach out to, you know, and ask them if they'd be interested in doing a referral post, or start engaging with them about what you think about them is special and why you think they would do great in our business, so that you're leading the conversation, as opposed to people that have this mindset of this, a little bit of a lazy mindset that I'm just going to post and wait for everyone to come to me. And I think we have to, you know, just like we've always been in our business, we have to really go after things.
I love that. Now,
you guys heard Lara talk about how we're all friends, we all love each other, but you know what? Instead of friending each other, follow each other. That's just, don't go and friend every single person on your team. Don't, that we can all support each other by following each other. Now that all public, you know, Facebook pages can be followed, it also doesn't take up all of your friend space. So there's my additional tiny piece of advice. I know you didn't ask me, but we're going to throw it out there. Suzanne?
Okay, so just staying in the game is a big process for a lot of people. And so I want to encourage everybody to work on your mindset and your determination that you will start somewhere. So wherever it is that you're beginning, whether you're just now getting started on social or you're more advanced, identify what it is that creates a feeling of fear within you, and decide that you are going to use that energy, that feeling of fear, and you're going to put that forth into your business and create some momentum with it, and just do the post that scares you. Do the live video that scares you, and just get over it, because every time you do these things that are going to grow and stretch your comfort zone, you're going to become so much stronger, and people will see this as they begin to follow what you're doing. So identify what makes you feel the fear and do it.
Love that. Mari?
Okay, so yes, I love all the advice given up here. It's amazing. Like Hazel's four E's, Lara, you talked about the FOMO, and tying into that, you're talking about fears. I know there's a lot of people in this room that are probably afraid to do live, to do Facebook Live, to do Instagram Live, Twitter Live, stories, like all this self-talk. Oh, I don't like myself. I don't look, oh my God, my eyes are all buggy today. Oh, my skin's not right. Oh, I didn't do my facial today. Whatever that conversation we have in our minds. Oh, I can't go live. But guess what? This is a beautiful, perfect opportunity you can do right now today if you haven't already been, because you can connect with all of your online audience and go, wow, this is such an amazing convention, and look at these products. Look at these. I'm hanging out with my friends here. I wish you could be here. This is such a great company, great culture, and just really sharing that enthusiasm, and people will feel, I have this saying, your vibe attracts your tribe. You've probably heard it before, but your vibe, you put it out there and just be you, and people are going to be drawn to you, and do that through live video.
All right, everybody, you heard that. Go live today. Okay, I have one more favor to ask you guys before we leave. We're going to take a selfie with all of you guys in the background, so stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Everyone up. All right, Suzanne, selfie stick now, not at the beginning. You guys ready to be in our picture? Oh, house lights are on. They're on. Okay, you guys. Are we ready? Are we ready? We feel bad that our backs are to you.